The constraints available in the menu adapt or change based on your selections. Some constraint types require selecting more than one sketch element. To add a constraint from the menu, select the sketch element you want to constrain, and then select the constraint type from the constraints menu. Select a single line, and then add a vertical constraint to make sure it's vertical. Now make the lines perpendicular. Select the two lines you want to constrain, then add a perpendicular constraint. You can create the following constraints using drag within a sketch. Connected points by dragging one point onto another point. Coincident by dragging a point onto a line or curve. Midpoint by dragging a point onto a line's midpoint indicated in purple. Points that are connected, coincident, or have a midpoint constraint are shown with a filled center. Unconnected points are free to move in any way within the sketch and are shown with a white center. The lock constraint locks a selected sketch element in its current position. To lock points, select an endpoint or center point in the sketch, then select the lock badge. You can also lock points by selecting lock from the constraints menu. Locked sketch points appear solid in color. You can remove constraints in the following ways. You can disconnect points by selecting a connected line, arc, endpoint, or center point. To disconnect, select the disconnect badge. You can also disconnect points by selecting disconnect from the constraints menu. To unlock a sketch element, select it, and then select the Unlock badge. You can select any constraint badges to highlight the relevant sketches. To delete the constraint, you can select the constraint and select Delete Constraints from the Sketch menu, or press Delete or Backspace on the keyboard.